Hello students, I welcome you in this video session of DAV Public School CCL Giridi. Today I, Shashwati Mukherjee, is going to discuss a chapter of Standard 12, that is Solid State.
Yes, Solid State. We all have studied in our junior classes that matter exists in three states of matter. Matter exists in three states, that is solid, liquid and gas. You have studied in standard 11 about liquid state of matter and gaseous state of matter. Today I am going to discuss solid state of matter. What is a solid? What is a solid? A solid is a state of matter in which the intermolecular forces of attraction between the particles is very high, intermolecular space is low, it is rigid, it is very less compressible, generally it is not compressible, it do not flow. These are the properties of solids we have studied in our junior classes. So let us recapitulate what are the characteristics of solid. Generally have rigid, solids are rigid. Then it has high intermolecular forces of attraction. Low intermolecular space. No fluidity. Then what are the properties you can say about solid? It is rigid, it has high intermolecular force of attraction, it has low intermolecular space, it has no fluidity. Gases and liquids have fluidity. Then you can say that it is not compressible. Generally it is not compressible. So these are the properties of solids. Okay, discuss this solid. We'll discuss solid. Solid is broadly classified into two. One is crystalline solid. Crystalline solid. Another is amorphous solid. Now, what I'm telling that solid is broadly classified into two. One is crystalline solid, another is amorphous solid. Now, what are crystalline solid? In crystalline solid, the particles are regularly arranged to give a definite pattern. In crystalline solid, the particles are regularly arranged to give a definite pattern. While in case of amorphous solid, the particles are not regularly arranged. Here the particles have regular arrangement. Here the particles have irregular arrangements. So it is giving a definite pattern and it is not giving a definite pattern. You can take up the example for crystalline solid like sodium chloride, then silicon carbide, then solid carbon dioxide, sugar, all these are examples of crystalline solid. Here you will find the arrangement of particles are regular, so they are giving a definite pattern. So if you are taking, if you want to explain, if you want to understand how the particles are arranged in NaCl, NaCl we all know the constituent particles are Na plus and Cl minus. Here
Na plus Cl minus Na plus Cl minus. Here Cl minus Na plus. Cl minus Na plus. Cl minus Na plus. Like this way it is arranged. So we can see that it is following a regular arrangement, and so it will form a definite pattern. But in case of amorphous solid, the particles are not regularly arranged. They have irregular arrangement. Some of the examples of amorphous solids are plastics. Then plastic, then coal also you can take. Coal. All these are examples of amorphous solid. Coal, you can see that the arrangement is irregular. So, coal is also an example of amorphous solid. Now, we'll discuss some more difference between amorphous and crystalline solid. Students will have to remember that these crystalline solids are known as true solids. They are known as true solids. True solids. While these amorphous solids are known as pseudo solids. Pseudo solids or supercooled liquids. What? They are known as true solids, and the amorphous solids are known as pseudo solids or supercooled liquids. Now, a question may arise in your mind that why it is known as pseudo solids or supercooled liquids. Amorphous solids have a tendency to flow. It do not flow like a true liquid. So, but it has a tendency to flow. When you go to visit a old monument, and if you are seeing the glass window, if you notice the glass window of a very old building, you will see that it is thin in the middle and thick at the bottom. Why? Because glass has a tendency to flow. Glass is a amorphous solid and it has a tendency to flow. So what you are finding, that in old windows, glass windows, you will find that in the middle it is thin and at the bottom it is thick. So first difference I told you between crystalline solid and amorphous solid. In crystalline solid, the particles are regularly arranged. In amorphous solid, it is irregularly arranged. Then, crystalline solids are known as true solids, whereas amorphous solids are known as pseudo solids or supercooled liquids. Then, crystalline solids have sharp melting point. Sharp melting point. It has crystalline solids at sharp melting point. Amorphous solid melts over a range of temperature. Softens, you can say, softens over a range of temperature. Range of temperature. So another difference I told you, that for every crystalline solid we have a sharp melting point, but amorphous solid softens over a range of temperature. Next, another difference we can say that crystalline solids are anisotropic. And amorphous solids are isotropic. It is a new topic for you. Anisotropic. What is the meaning of this? Anisotropic, I am explaining. Crystalline solids have different physical properties like refractive index, different direction, have different physical properties in different directions.
What I am telling, anisotropic and isotropic. These crystalline solids are anisotropics because they have different physical properties like refractive index in different direction. Whereas amorphous solids are isotropic because they have same physical properties like refractive index in different direction. Then next point, what can we say? That crystalline solids have clean cleavage. Clean cleavage means if you cut crystalline solid with any sharp thing, then you will get a clean cleavage. But in case of an amorphous solid, you will not get clean cleavage. Not clean cleavage. We are not getting a clean cleavage. If you cut it, what will happen? Will not get clean cleavage. So, what I told, that in crystalline solids, arrangement of particles are regular and they follow a definite pattern. Amorphous solids, the arrangement of particles are not regular, so they follow irregular pattern. So, we can say that they are known as long-range ordered solid. Long-range ordered solid. While amorphous solids are also known as short-range ordered solid. Short-range ordered solids. They are crystalline solids are known as true solids, while amorphous solids are known as pseudo solids or supercooled liquids. Then crystalline solids have sharp melting point, whereas amorphous solids get softened over a range of temperature. Then crystalline solids are anisotropic, that is they have different physical properties in different directions. They have same physical properties in different directions. Then you can cut it, when you are cutting it with a sharp edge tool, you are getting clean cleavage. Here you are not getting clean cleavage or unclean cleavage also you can write. Not clean cleavage or unclean cleavage. Then it is having long range, or it is known as long range ordered solid. It is known as short range ordered solids.